I did have a real job at one point. That was with a nuclear company. They made nuclear fuel, El Dorado Nuclear it was called. And that was the chemistry of uranium, which is really interesting chemistry. It's my favorite element, if I can have a favorite element. But that sort of shaped the way I think, because that was the first real job I had. And it was quite industrial. I had a boss. There was something you had to do at the end of each week or each month. There was a target. So it's kind of the way I think. And I think I teach in a similar fashion. There's got to be a reason for teaching it. Otherwise, it's just a waste of time. So I don't like giving students busy work that just occupies their hands or their minds. I like giving them work that leads to some sort of result that's tangible. They can understand why chemistry is important. I hope they gain an appreciation for chemistry, and I hope it's adequate that some of them will be convinced that it's worth studying more chemistry. Unfortunately, a lot of people get turned off in high school, which is a shame, because if they hadn't been turned off, we could at least keep it going in university and there would be more chemists, because the world needs more chemists. So if they don't get turned off, that's good. I hope that they learn enough that they realize that it's useful chemistry and interesting, and therefore they should come back and study more. And if they ever turned into chemistry majors, wow, that'd be great. Yeah, I go skiing whenever I can. We had a phase change the other day. This is good. That silly water turned into snow. This is great. Like to ski, like to sail, like to cycle. But it's this intercession where there's not enough snow, but it's too cold to go sailing or cycling. I don't know what to do. So just keep working. My mentor, Peter Cruz, he gave me a bumper sticker when I was in second year, and I still have it. It says, honk if you passed PCHEM, which is physical chemistry. And I remember thinking that was special enough that almost 40 years later, I still have it, and I know where it is. So it seems to strike a chord with students. When they win one of these, it's like they won a Nobel Prize kind of thing. The sticker says, what in the world isn't chemistry? And so I pose that question at the beginning of the school year. And I say to them, what I mean by this is, what in the physical world that you can see or taste or touch or smell or whatever isn't chemistry? And I've never had a good answer. They try things like a vacuum. I say, well, vacuums is nothing, so we can't, you know. Or they say, you know, mathematics, that's not chemistry. Well, yeah, but that's not part of the physical world either. So the only time I've ever given a prize for the answer to that question is young student said, the only thing that's not chemistry is the relationship with my last boyfriend. So I gave her the prize, but otherwise, no prizes for that, because everything is chemistry. It's that simple.